My name is Patrick Heist, and we are at Ferm Solutions and Wilderness Trail Distillery here in Danville, Kentucky. Since graduating from the University of Kentucky multiple times, my last time I graduated was 2003 with a PhD in plant pathology from the College of Agriculture. Not long after that, I got into this industry as a consultant, and then not long after that, my business partner and I, who he's also a University of Kentucky graduate from engineering, we put together this company, Ferm Solutions, that markets products to fuel and beverage alcohol facilities, as well as offers technical support and consultation for troubleshooting at distilleries all over the world. We currently work with about 500 plus distilleries, both large and small. We do a lot of training for distilleries, and that's one of the reasons why we started Wilderness Trail Distillery. That process has been going on for about 3 years now. So in terms of our bourbon production, we're about a year to 2 years away from releasing our first Kentucky straight bourbon. Bourbon stillage is a byproduct from the bourbon production process. So the leftover water, the leftover grains, which doesn't have a lot of sugar, but it's got a lot of fiber and other oils and proteins. We actually have one farmer here in Danville that takes all of our stillage and feeds it to his cattle. Most farmers and other people that are interested in the nutritional qualities of that stillage are interested in the solid portion of it. They are actually interested in using the liquid portion of the stillage, they being the Center for Applied Energy Research at University of Kentucky.
My name is Steve Lipka. I'm an associate director at the Center for Applied Energy Research at the University of Kentucky. I'm a materials engineer, material scientist, and I use electrochemistry as a tool to make useful devices. We're always looking for precursor materials that are abundant, sustainable, waste products that can be converted into value-added products that, in our case, can be used to store electrochemical energy.
Steve Lipka has been working on bourbon stillage for a year, and not long after he started this research, he partnered with Wilderness Trail Distillery. So how do you take liquid stillage and end up with batteries? Lipka's lab uses hydrothermal carbonization, a process that takes water and a carbon source, like stillage, heats it up under pressure, and ends up with solid material that is made up of tiny, uniformly sized particles.
Using this hydrothermal carbonization, you can tailor the materials. You can tailor their composition, their bulk and surface composition. You can tailor their density, their electrical conductivity, and their size. And also, most importantly, their phase purity. Having carbons that have high purity are very, very important in a lot of electrochemical storage applications. We take these materials, which we refer to as green material, and we then do additional post-processing, typically thermal processes, to convert it into useful materials that can be used for batteries. So we've made cathodes or positive electrode materials for primary carbon monofluoride batteries, which are the most energy dense primary batteries in the world. And they make very, very good materials.
Lipka started this work on next generation lightweight energy dense power sources with funding from the Office of Naval Research.
We've also used these as carbons that can be used in secondary batteries like lithium-ion. The benefits of lithium-ion batteries are that they're very energy dense systems.
Lithium-ion batteries are expensive when compared to other battery systems. Using a waste product like stillage could bring down production costs and reduce the reliance on other, more expensive sources of carbon. Lipka's team is making electrochemical capacitors from stillage. Capacitors excel at rapid charge and discharge. This makes them ideal for capturing energy from alternative sources like solar or wind, then providing a quick burst of power when the electric grid has a momentary outage. Lipka is also using bourbon stillage to create cheaper activated carbons for water filtration with funds from General Electric Appliances in Louisville.
Yeah, when we started working with our project with General Electric, we took first the bourbon stillage and converted that to these carbon-rich materials. We then use a process called activation. Exposes the material to a steam environment, and we create high porosity, high surface area materials. And then those materials are used to see how well they can reduce chloramine, which is a disinfectant used in municipal drinking water supplies, or remove chloroform. The immediate use is on the consumer end. If you have a refrigerator that has a water supply that makes ice, for example, or dispenses water, there's a activated carbon filter in every one of those refrigerators. The Center for Applied Energy Research has a rich history of supporting research activities that are critical and germane to the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And I think it's of great value for us to look at industries here in Kentucky that we can use those products in a very useful way and have a sustainable type of business. I think the most exciting thing for me and for most people is that you can take a product that is considered waste in many industries and repurpose it or convert it into value-added product that has tremendous utility. I would like to get some of the distilleries interested in this and see this have some traction at the end of the day and turn it into a business. I think it can be done. And again, it'll be another wonderful Kentucky story.